chord is a set of notes played together, and the name of this chord depends on the root note, on how many notes there are in it, and the interval that separates each note. Triads are chords that are made of three notes. They are at the basis of all chords. To build them, we'll need a root note, which will give the chord its name, then a third and a fifth. So if I want to make a chord of C, I'll take a C, the third E, and a fifth G. That makes a C major chord. Because between C and E, there are two tones, which is an interval of a major third. And between C and G, there is an interval of 3.5 tone, which is an interval of a perfect fifth. So a root note plus a major third plus a perfect fifth makes a major chord, which is considered to be a happy chord. It sounds happy. To make it a minor chord, I have to lower the third by a semitone, so it becomes E flat, and the interval between the root note C and E flat is 1.5 tones, which is an interval of a minor third. The interval between C and G is still a perfect fifth. So a root note plus a minor third plus a perfect fifth make a minor chord. That's considered to be a sad chord. It sounds kinda sad. The only difference between a major chord and a minor chord is the third. This note alone will determine the state of the whole chord. And you can actually change the order of the notes, the voicing. It will still stay the same chord. For example, if I write my C major chord, E, G, C, it can be described as an E chord with a third and a sixth, but in fact it is still a C major chord. That's what we call an inversion. If I remove the third in my chord, the chord is neither minor or major. This is what we call a power chord. This is just a root note with a fifth, and it's used a lot by guitarists. So I can alter my third to make my chord major or minor, but I can also alter the fifth. If I move my perfect fifth up a semitone, it becomes augmented, and if I move it down a semitone, it becomes diminished. So a chord with a major third and an augmented fifth is called an augmented chord, such as C, E, G sharp. That's a C augmented chord. It's considered to be more of a bright chord. The other way around, a chord with a minor third and a diminished fifth is called a diminished chord, such as C, E flat, G flat. It's considered to be a dark chord. And that's pretty much all the most used triads, major, minor, augmented and diminished. We could create a triad with a major third and a diminished fifth, for example, which I heard was called a hard diminished chord, which sounds harsh, but it's not really used. In fact, if we see the three notes together, C, E and G flat, it's often as being part of another chord, other than C, often with at least a fourth note added. So this hard diminished chord with a major third and a diminished fifth is not really used as is. In fact, every chord can be considered as a superposition of third. A major chord is a major third plus a minor third. A minor chord is a minor third plus a major third. An augmented chord is two major thirds stacked up, and a diminished chord is two minor thirds stacked up. Maybe that explains a bit better why we don't really use the major third with a diminished fifth. And then there wouldn't be an interval of third between the third and the fifth in our chord. So when you're using a scale, you can build your chords by stacking up thirds. In practice, that means that when you're using a scale, you can build your chords by taking one note every two, starting with the root note. The space between each note will then define the nature of the chord. So in the scale of C major, for instance, that's all the white key on the keyboard, if I build a C chord, I start from C, I leave a note, then take a note, that's E, I leave a note, then take a note, that's G. So we have our major chord C, E, G that we had before. But we can build a chord for every note in the scale in the exact same way. So for a D chord, I start from D, leave a note, take a note, leave a note, take a note, so we have D, F, A. With 1.5 tones between D and F, that's a minor third. And with 2 tones between F and A, that's a major third. So a minor third with a major third, that's a minor chord. If we build every chord over the C major scale, we find that our C chord is major, the D and E chords are minor, the F and G chords are major, the A chord is minor, and the B chord is diminished. In the same way we refer to every note in the scale with Arabic numerals, we refer to the chords of a scale with Roman numerals. That will come handy to talk about our chord progressions. Just know that these are called degrees. The first degree, second degree, third degree, etc. The fifth degree is a bit special. It's called the dominant, but we'll get back to it. In the next video, we'll see how to spice this up a little bit by adding extra notes to these chords and create extended chords. We'll have a closer look to some of them and see how all of that is built. If you like this video, give it a like, subscribe and hit the bell button if you don't want to miss the next one. In the meantime, thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.